I'm too busy cooking. I don't know what the hell is going on.
All right, you guys, we're at the Battle of the Bays, very first tournament. We're prepping the swordfish. So I got this recipe from Harold of Davis Boats. Thank you, Harold, for sharing this recipe. We're gonna make a cactus salsa and we're gonna put it all over some swordfish that we're putting on the grill.
Cactus leaves,
nopales,
green onions, some nice tomatoes. I picked out Romas. The reason I'm using Romas is they've got less juice in them and more meat. These are also excellent for tomato sauce. The Italians love to use Roma tomatoes. And I'm gonna add a couple of habaneros for some heat. And don't worry, the grill mellows the habanero heat out. And believe it or not, along with the acidity of the tomato, the habanero almost disappears. It's got a little background heat to it. Here we go. There's no olive oil, no salt, nothing is required. Everything's gonna be added when we chop everything up and put it in the bowl. Oh yeah, look at that. Look at the nice color on that. That color means flavor. God, this smells so good. Oh man. So you guys aren't gonna believe how easy this is. Habaneros. Be careful with the habaneros. After you handle these habaneros, be sure and wash your hands with dish soap. Not hand soap. Dish soap will effectively get rid of the oils from your hands. Believe me, you don't want to touch your eyes, your nose, anything. Be careful when you're chopping these guys up. And give them a real fine chop, too. You don't want anyone to get a big chunk of habanero. Throw the stem away. Now it's time to chop up these guys. Mmm, smells so good. Okay, long strips. Long, thin strips, probably between an eighth and a quarter of an inch in width. And I'm gonna add about a tablespoon of salt, a tablespoon of pepper. Come closer, take a look at this. We're gonna put this in the refrigerator to cool off. I could just dive into this. And we're gonna start grilling up our swordfish. Now the swordfish I got from the tournament, but because it was never frozen, we got it fresh. I froze it for a couple of days. I've taken it out, thawed it out. We're gonna put it on the grill. And it's already got the marinade on it, so we're getting really close. Now because I'm using hardwood coals, lump coal, I'm cooking at about maybe 800-900 degrees. Ordinary coals cook at 500 degrees, like the briquettes you get from Kingsford, but they don't impart the flavor and they don't sear anywhere near as these hardwood charcoals. Now because we're cooking up swordfish and it's a more firm and dense meat, the cooking time is going to be a little longer than usual, as opposed to, let's say, a halibut or maybe even a white sea bass. Oh, look at that. That's perfect. All right, fellas, it's time to plate up. Oh my God, this is my favorite time here. Oh, look at that. Oh my God. Oh my God. So here you have it, boys. Cactus salsa, grilled swordfish. This is as simple as it gets, but believe me, this salsa is so authentic. Mmm. And the swordfish, oh. Mmm. boy, that marinade with that soy sauce, the cactus, a little bit of a late kick with a habanero. This is a home run. I can't wait to gobble this down. You guys need to give this a try. Thanks for joining me today inside the belly. I hope you guys try cactus. You're gonna fall in love with it just like I have. We'll see you soon.